السلام عليكم، لا تنسوا الاعجاب بالفيديو والاشتراك في القناة تشجيعا لنا لنستمر بنشر المزيد ان شاء الله.
This is strength. Ukrainian Bayraktar TB2 drones successfully attack Russian convoys.
السلام عليكم مشاهدينا ومرحبا بكم. أثبتت طائرات البرقدار تو 2
against the Russian قوتها في الميدان مرة أخرى، وهذه المرة ضد ما يوصف بثاني أقوى جيش على وجه البسيطة، والتي تعتبر من أهم الأسلحة في صناعة الدفاع التركية. أثبتت نجاحها مرة أخرى من خلال تدمير دبابات الجيش الروسي واحدة تلو الأخرى، حيث بعد أن وصلت دفعة جديدة من هذه الطائرات إلى أوكرانيا، بدأ العمل اليوم، حيث انتشرت مقاطع فيديو وصور جديدة لتدمير أرتال عسكرية روسية وإمدادات وقود، حيث ضرب الجيش الأوكراني ناقلات الوقود التي تزود الدبابات الروسية بالوقود باستخدام الطائرات بدون تيار البيرقدار. والدبابات الروسية تنتظر تقدم الناقلات، لكن يبدو أن الناقلات ستتأخر قليلا حسب السفارة الأوكرانية في تركيا. وتظهر فيديوهات أخرى استيلاء الأوكرانيين على الآلات العسكرية الروسية التي هجرها الجيش الروسي على طريق جوتمير السريع بالقرب من مكاريف، وذلك نظرا لتدمير إمدادات الوقود، مما جعل الروس يتخلون عن المدرعات العسكرية الخاصة بهم، وفي المظاهر دمرت ثوار الأوكرانيون أقوى مدفعية العدو ليلا واستولوا على البطارية بأكملها، حيث يلاحظ أن البيرقدار مرت من هناك بمجرد أن تم تدمير بعض المدافع. فر الجنود الروس تاركين جميع الأسلحة هناك، وتقدم الثوار وسيطروا على هذه المعدات العسكرية. وأفاد رئيس إدارة ولاية خاركيف الإقليمية أن قوات الدفاع الجوي التابعة للقوات المسلحة قد دمرت طائرة هجومية روسية أخرى من طراز سو 25 بالقرب من خاركيف. والآن إجمالي الخسائر القتالية للجيش الروسي منذ
Ukraine and Turkey have close defense industry cooperation, a relationship that has flourished in recent years. The TB2's producer, Baker, which has close ties to Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan's family, was building a plant in Ukraine before the war. Ukrainian companies also produce the TB2's engines, and Turkey has sold more than 20 Bayraktars to Kiev over the course of 2 years. Some experts believe the number of TB2s in the Ukrainian arsenal could be even higher. Many observers believe that Russia's offensive is not going as planned, and it was foolish of Moscow to send in the troops without first wiping out Ukraine's air force, including its drones. Yet Russia's failure to take out the TB2s could be down to several reasons. First off, it doesn't have air supremacy over all of Ukraine's airspace. Besides, the Russian military struck a large number of Ukrainian air bases, but some still have operational runways and facilities. Manned and unmanned operations of Ukraine are attacked, but not totally disrupted. Robert Lee, a senior fellow at the Foreign Policy Research Institute, says Russia had the capability to destroy TB2s on the ground and at airfields at the beginning of the war, but failed to do so for some reason. In addition, it doesn't appear that air defenses that escort ground forces into battle were prepared to face the TB2. Not fully clear why that is, he told NEE. The footage released by the Ukrainian military indicates TB2s haven't really been threatened by any air defense systems. Evidence so far shows most sorties being carried out easily and without retaliation. So far, there is only open source confirmation of one downed TB2, although the Russian Defense Ministry claimed that it shot down three of them over the weekend. Kasa Pavlov says one of the videos being circulated online shows a TB2 destroying a bomb, a Russian mobile air defense system. Kasapoglu says another incident involving the destruction of a convoy belonging to Russia, allied Chechen fighters near Kiev was far more significant, as these troops are highly experienced units known for their brutality, which could have tipped the tactical situation there. One Turkish source told MEE that the Ukrainians have been using what he calls hit-and-run tactics to overwhelm the Russian troops. The source said TB2's low visibility and detectability due to their low radar cross-section values helped them considerably against the Russian defense systems. In the Karabakh War, drones were decisive weapons. In Ukraine, they act as tactical force multipliers and, interestingly, psychological warfare assets in the digital infosphere. Others had questioned the effectiveness of Russian electronic warfare systems against the TB2 before the Ukraine war even broke out. Analysts Tijan Mitsa and Joost Olemans, who run a popular defense blog called Oryx Spionica, wrote in December that Russia's most modern electronic warfare systems fail to combat TB2 in Nagorno-Karabakh. According to the chief of Ukraine's Air Force, Lieutenant General Mykola Olechek, Turkish-made Bayraktar TB2 drones have carried out strikes on Russian troops in the Kherson region and near the city of Mala, about 60 miles northwest of Kiev. In support of a statement, Ukrainian Air Force released footage of a Russian convoy consisting of more than a dozen vehicles, including Buk M12 surface-to-air missile systems, blown to pieces by the strike near Malin district of the Zhytomyr region.